everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about consumer and producer surplus. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to find consumer and producer surplus. But before we do that, and this would always be the case, you'd need to find the equilibrium quantity and the equilibrium price. So first we'll go ahead and find equilibrium quantity and price. And the way that we'll do that is by setting the demand and supply curves equal to one another. So we'll get negative 0.4Q, this is the demand curve, plus 23, and we'll set that equal to the supply curve, so 0.03Q squared plus 3. And the way we usually end up solving for Q in this case is by moving everything to one side so that this equation is set equal to 0, and then factoring. So we'll move everything from the left side over to the right side so that our q squared term stays positive. So we'll get 0.03 q squared. And then that means that we've added 0.4 q. And then we'll subtract 23 from both sides and get a minus 23. Minus 23 gives us a minus 20. Now I'm going to go ahead, just to make this a little bit easier on ourselves, and multiply through by 100 so that we eliminate the decimals. So 0.03 times 100 gives us 3q squared. 0.4 times 100 gives us 40q. And then negative 20 times 100 gives us a negative 2,000. And now if we factor this, we'll end up with 3q, and I'm just going to go ahead and put my factors in, 3q, and then 2,000 we can factor as 20 and 100. So we'd end up with, let's see, minus 20 and plus 100, I think. So that would give us 3q squared minus 60q plus 100q would be plus 40q minus 2,000. Great. So now we can solve each of these factors separately for Q. If we solve the first one, 3q plus 100 is equal to 0, we would subtract 100 from both sides and then divide by 3, so we'd get q equals negative 1/3. And if we solve this factor for q, obviously we'll get q equal to 20. Because quantity can't be negative, this solution is not feasible. So our only solution for Q is Q equal to 20. So Q equal 20 is the equilibrium quantity. Now we can use this, plug it back into either the demand or the supply equation, and get the equilibrium price. So let's go ahead and plug it back into the demand equation. So we'll say the demand equation, when we plug in 20 for Q, is going to give us negative 0.4 times 20 plus 23. So negative 0.4 times 20 is going to be a negative 8 plus 23 gives us 15. So price, equilibrium price, is going to be equal to 15. So those are our equilibrium quantities and equilibrium quantity and equilibrium price. And now that we have those, we can go ahead and solve for consumer surplus and producer surplus. So let's go ahead and start with consumer surplus. I've got the formulas up here for consumer surplus and producer surplus. And if we go ahead and find consumer surplus, we're just plugging equilibrium and quantity, equilibrium quantity and price and the demand function into the formula. So you can see that we're going to integrate from 0 to the equilibrium quantity, which we already know is 20. And then we're going to plug in the demand equation, so negative 0.4q plus 23 dq, so that's the end of our integral, but then we have to subtract equilibrium quantity times equilibrium price. 20 times 15 is 300, so we'll end up subtracting 300. And when we integrate this, we'll get the integral from 0 to 20. I don't need to do that. So if we integrate, we'll add 1 to the exponent here and then divide by the new exponent, which is going to be 2. So we'll end up with a negative 0.2q squared plus 23q. And we're going to be evaluating that on the range 0 to 20, and then we're going to subtract 300 from that. So remember, with a definite integral, we plug in the top number first. So we'll get negative 0.2 times 20 squared, which is going to be 400, plus 23 times 20. And then we would subtract from that what we get when we plug in 0. But if we plug in 0, obviously this term will be 0 and this term will be 0. So we really just need to subtract 300. And when we end up doing this out on our calculator, we'll end up with consumer surplus equal to 80. So that's our consumer surplus. And now we just need to find producer surplus. So to do that, let's go ahead and erase this stuff over here on the left. But quantity is 20 and price is 15. And we can go ahead and erase this stuff over here so we've got space for producer surplus. So to find producer surplus, we will multiply equilibrium quantity by equilibrium price, which we already know to be 300. And then we'll subtract from that the integral from 0 to equilibrium quantity, which is 20. And then we plug in the supply curve. So the supply curve is 0.03 q squared plus 3. dq. So now we can integrate 300 minus, and we'll go ahead and draw a bracket here because we only are going to be integrating from 0 to 20 the supply curve here, the integral of the supply curve. So we'll end up with, for the integral, 0.01 q cubed plus 3q on the range 0 to 20. So we'll end up with 300 minus 0.01 times 20 cubed plus 3 times 20. And normally we would subtract what we get when we plug in 0, but again, we'll get 0 here and 0 here, so we don't really need to say minus 0. And when we do this out on our calculator, we will find that the producer surplus is going to be equal to 160. So that's it. That's how you find equilibrium quantity and price, and then use those to find consumer surplus and producer surplus. So I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!